Hey guys, Jazib here from the Nerd Mac, and today here is the first look at the S10, S10 Plus from the launch event in Pakistan. So thanks to Samsung, we got a chance to have an early look at the S10 and the S10 Plus during the dealer's event. If you're wondering, yes, the official launch event is still pending. Anyways, getting back to the device, S10 is Samsung's 10th anniversary phone of Galaxy S series. And I must say, the S10 is really beautiful in terms of the design. It comes with Samsung's new dynamic AMOLED display, which is precisely laser cut for the two camera holes in the front. I personally have never liked all the variety of notches that are now currently present in the phones, and this is way better than the notches we have seen recently. I must say that apart from a fresh design, we have this new HDR10 supported display, and as usual, this is the brightest and perfect display in a phone you can get. Also, the S10 and the S10 Plus are first devices to feature in-screen ultrasonic fingerprint sensor. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough time to test it thoroughly. Also, Samsung decided to stick with headphone jack as well. On the back, we have the three new cameras and sensors. Like the S9, there's a power button on the right side and a volume plus a Bixby button on the left. Also, Samsung is now allowing you to remap the Bixby button to other apps as well, but you still cannot map this button onto the Google Assistant. The build quality is really premium as being a flagship device. On the bottom, we have a speaker, mic, and a USB-C type port. S10 also features wireless power charging like the Mate 20 Pro. Moving on, here are the specs for all the three models: S10, S10 Plus, and S10e. The only difference between the S10 and the S10 Plus is the dual pixel front facing camera and a bigger battery. On the back, there are three cameras, which also include a wide angle sensor as well. Here are all the five camera details, as you can see here. S10 is running on Samsung's new One UI, which is running on Android 9.0. One UI is the next iteration of Samsung's skin on top of Android. Samsung finally got it right with One UI for both large screens. Basically, Samsung has pushed its content down the screen for easy access. S10 comes with three new cameras as told previously. The best thing is that you can easily switch between all these cameras, either it's wide, telephoto, or a portrait lens. Hopefully, when we get the device for the review, we would be able to tell you more about the device and test it in a better way. So, is this device worth 175,000 rupees? I guess we will find out in due time. Moreover, Samsung is also offering a pre-order bonus as well. So stay tuned for more future info on the S10 on the Nerd Mag.